So I think Deutsche Bank is in the process of redefining their business model, right? They had a very outwardly oriented business model, and they're now looking as to where they should concentrate core. The key issue for European banks is not Deutsche. The key issue for European bank remains the holding of government bonds. And part of the underperformance of all European banks has been because the notion of Italy has reintroduced the notion of sovereign risk in Europe. And I think that's the key issue for European banks. So if you're an investor there, it's about sovereign risk.
That's a nice way of putting it. Is Deutsche Bank in crisis or not?
I don't think so. I think Deutsche Bank is in the midst of redefining its business model. Mm-hmm. And it's doing so while having to live with the legacy of many years of overexpansion.
It's shrinking dramatically, though.
No, it is. And it's going to have to figure out what its core business is. And it's not as simple as for banks here, because their domestic base is not large enough to be the core business. It can be a core business, but it cannot be the core business.
Separately, our Fed, the ECB, ECB is probably going to raise rates in a couple years. I mean, if they're on the same track as our Fed, there's trillions of dollars of corporate debt out there. A lot of it's held by private equity firms above LIBOR. I don't want to be LIBOR-ing, but right. It's important. Is there any industry that you think that is particularly at risk from rising rates on the debt side?
So I think you've got to look not at the industry, but the amount of leverage. And I think people who look at that closely worry about certain segments of high yield, where there's been a massive expansion in leverage. So that's where I would focus. You know, Brian, I have a very simple test. Whether you are an equity investor or a bond investor, you ask yourself three questions. How strong is the balance sheet, first and foremost? Secondly, are there any obvious mismatches in terms of maturity? Mm-hmm. And third, how strong is the business model? And that are the questions that we had forgotten about during a period of massive liquidity. And we're starting to realize now that we have to ask these questions again.
It's because the oil story a couple years ago, the reason that we got on it was not an oil story. It was
Correct.
Actually a debt. I mean, it was, but it was a debt story.
Right.
And I wonder, Andrew, or I know you guys, you've talked about this, a deal book, and yeah. You guys have written about it. How big is this debt? We're seeing a super tanker of interest rates move. It's huge and slow, but it moves everything in its wake. And I wonder if we're not talking enough about the debt side of the story.
I think it's a huge debt side of the story. But the question is, when does that
super tanker run aground?
When does it run aground? When does the trust run out? When's the confidence game over? You probably have a better sense of that than I do.
No, I think the game continues for a while. But it's interesting to see the BIS this week join the IMF in warning about corporate debt.
Right.
Right. So it's getting the attention of the multilaterals. And once it gets the attention of the multilaterals, it's only a matter of time until others start focusing.
Bank of International Settlements.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.